hey, Pastor Steve Waldron. Well, this standard reference work, Noah Webster's 1828 Dictionary of the American Language, you can get this from church publications and also local church Bible publications for about $45 and some shipping. As a matter of fact, this is July 2017. I think Church Bible's got a 15% off thing going on right now. And this is just a monument of English literature. Noah Webster, he was such a patriot. What he was trying to do is he was trying to Americanize English. He wanted a separate language. You know, a lot of people don't know it was actually in the discussions because of Chaim Solomon, the financier of the nascent republic back in the 1770s, to make Hebrew the official language of the United States of America because they wanted to be different from Great Britain. So Noah Webster, he came up with an American dictionary of the English language. Of course, he did the blue-backed speller before that. He was editor of the Federalist publication. And to do this, it took him 22 years and he learned 28 languages. I just want to read to you some of the languages that he learned to do this. It took him 26 years, excuse me, to complete. To evaluate the etymology of words, Webster learned 28 languages, including Old English, which is Anglo-Saxon, Gothic, German, Greek, Latin, Italian, Spanish, French, Dutch, Welsh, Russian, Hebrew, Aramaic, Persian, Arabic, and Sanskrit. And Webster hoped to standardize American speech since Americans in different parts of the country use different languages. They spelled, pronounced, and used English words differently. And so he completed this in January of 1825 while he was in the UK. It is absolutely fantastic. What a lot of people, homeschoolers and Bible believers like, first of all, it's got basically all the words, like there's about 800 or so archaic words in the King James that aren't used a lot anymore, and they're in here. And he goes into etymologies of everything. And then so often he uses either Bible verses as like the example of a word, like, you know, a bet or something like that, or a junct, or, you know, he'll use a Bible verse to show how the word is properly used, or some moral lesson because of the great Christian character of America during this time period. So I recommend this to everybody. You can get this on disc. I'm sorry, I'm just not a big computer guy. I wish I was, but maybe an EMP attack or something's going to happen, and then I don't want an EMP attack to happen. Don't get me wrong. I do not want that. But I'm saying, you know, then it's back to books. It's back to the Stone Age. But this is a great, great resource. And, of course, we still talk about Webster's Dictionary today. Yeah, it's this Webster's. I think Miriam bought this out, bought the rights to it after he passed away in like 1843, 1844. And I've done a review on the Webster Bible where he tried to Americanize the King James Version of the Bible, which I still prefer just a regular King James. I think it's more accurate. As smart as he was, I don't think he did that quite right. But I understood what he was doing. He was trying to separate us from the United Kingdom. So God bless. He was at the time of John Quincy Adams III, Monroe, all this. Talk with you later. God bless you in Jesus' name.